think one of my fondest memories as a kid was going to the barbershop with my dad, and it was this different kind of father-son connection. He was teaching you how to behave in public around other men. And those are memories that I look back on so fondly that that's something that I can never, ever feel again, you know, now that I'm getting older, but I can kind of recreate that here for other people.
Sure.
Chris is wild with his thoughts. It's like, he calls me, he's like, oh my God, I had this vision.
I was at my day job and it just kind of hit me. Just the name, the Modern Man Barbershop and Gentleman Supply. And so I texted Emily and I said, how about the Modern Man Barbershop and Gentleman Supply? She says, I love it. What is it? I said, well, it's you know, it's a manly place, and you guys go in for hot shaves, you know, and they get laid back with the towels on their faces, and you know, and they drink whiskey.
And I was like, oh my gosh, I'm on board. Give it to me. Let's do this.
What can I do for you? An
appointment? Originally, the Modern Man Barbershop and Gentleman Supply was referring to the barbershop and the grooming products that we were carrying. That idea has evolved, and the Gentleman Supply is now anything that a guy might need. Whether it be the whiskey at the bar, you know, good conversation. To set the mood, you come up, you got my pop behind the bar, this big old mustache, and there's, you know, food cooking in the crock pot. It's very, you know, small, intimate space. We want it to be the kind of place where you can actually sit and have a long chat over a couple Manhattans, you know, and order some good food. When I was first about to open up the shop with Emily, my dad says, Chris, just make sure you take care of your neighbors. So what we've done since day one here, we've made it very clear that if you're out of work, you've got a job interview lined up, but you can't afford, you know, a haircut or a shave, come on in. You're gonna get your whiskey, you're gonna get your cigar, you're gonna get a shave, you're gonna get a haircut, and we're gonna send you out the door saying good luck. It's hard to ask for help, so that's why we offer. It's an old saying, you're only as good as your last haircut. So for me, I want the people that are driven to be in competition with themselves to make every service their best service.
I still remember the first day I got my clippers at beauty school, and I was so scared. I'm like, couldn't do it. But, you know, I kicked that, and since then I've apprenticed. I've worked on Portland Fashion Week. I've done a cover for magazines, and now I'm working here, so I'm doing something right.
You know, there's a lot of master barbers out there that would love to work at a busy shop. If they walk in my door, okay, you can cut hair. Can you talk to people? Can you talk to that person that's in your chair and genuinely find a common ground there?
Sure.
I actually post on Facebook all the time, like, come get a free drink, a haircut, and a therapy session at the Modern Man. Me personally, wherever I go, if I feel comfortable with that person or place, then I'm just gonna keep going and I'm gonna tell all my friends about it. I think that's definitely what keeps people coming back.
I'm not concerned about having, we have the top rated stylist in Portland and 50, I don't care about that. Titles, blah, 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 you know. I'd rather have someone that cares about the person in their chair. And I mean, obviously, you gotta cut a good head of hair.